who is really interested in the welfare of the disabled and also to improve the this innovative program, there is a district mental program. After the post-independence, there is a only innovative program which is formulated by the government of India is the district mental health program. It is a community-based mental health program. And in Tamil Nadu, we are the highest one and we are implementing in 16 districts in Tamil Nadu district mental health program. And so far we have completed 3 districts and in 13 districts we are implementing this program and we have submitted the proposal for 6 more districts. This is the name of the district. And the proposed district is Coimbatore, Dindukal, Pudukkottai, Sivagangai, Thoothukudi and Vilupuram. But unfortunately, the Nilagiri is left out. And the aim of the district mental health program, my dear ladies and gentlemen, according to the WHO, 3% of the population is suffering from the serious type of psychiatric illness who need immediate help. And you can imagine the population of this great country. So many millions are really suffering from this psychiatric illness. For such a huge amount of population, the number of psychiatrists in this country is very, very less. That is less than 10,000. Because most of the psychiatrists who got a degree from Tamil Nadu or anywhere in India, they are more bothered about the mental health of the UK rather than the India. They are doing a lot of community work in the United Kingdom. Now, in this confusion, we find it very difficult to get the proper psychiatrist for this program. And how to bridge up the gap? On one side, the need is more. On the other side, the availability is less, service is less. So to bridge up the gap, this mental health program comes into the hand. And according to the aims, one, availability and accessibility of the mental health care. One. And availability and accessibility of the mental health care, that is the basic mental health care, not the sophisticated mental health care, the basic mental health care at the rural areas of this country. And second, integration of the basic mental health care with the generalized services to promote the community participation, to increase the awareness, and also early detection and treatment, and also they should not travel long distances, and to take off the pressure from the mental hospitals to reduce the stigma and also to give the basic treatment and if possible they should rehabilitate at the rural area. This is the aims of the district mental health programs and the objectives of the district mental health program. And we have got a beautiful methodology in Tamil Nadu and there are 3 directives, separate directives. One is a director of medical education, then another is a director of medical services, and another is the director of primary health services. The director of medical education, they are primarily educating. That is, they are primarily responsible for the medical education. And in this program, they are formulating, they are giving guidelines for the guidelines for the training of the doctors, paramedical and non-medical people. And director of the medical services, they are the important people who are involved in the treatment facilities. So they are in charge of the treatment facilities. And what about the director of primary health services? They are in charge of the primary health physician who are working in the rural area. So in the district mental health program, 3 important directives directly involved. That is the director of medical education who is in charge for training, and director of medical services who are in charge of the treatment, and director of primary health services from where these benefits is going. We are giving the training to the primary health doctors who are working at the village level. So here, the coordination of these 3 departments is very essential. But unfortunately, the ego between the 3 departments is very, very high. And the communication, practically the 3 departments, they are working like an island. So you can imagine my position, that is why I am growing the beard. And here, the administrative pattern, the project director, that is the director of rural health services, and the second store nodal officer, and then the director, that's the institute of mental health, that is who is in charge of IEC activities and training, and the project officers, that is a dean who is in charge of training and the IEC activity, joint director of health who is in charge of treatment facilities. So this is the administrative matter. There is a DMS is a project director and state organization. This is one of the important thing on the which the Tamil Nadu government they took a major step. After seeing the confusion, after seeing the importance of the coordinated activity, they have created a separate post called the state nodal officer for district development program. And director, IMS director, he is in charge of the training. And the dean of the concerned district medical colleges, they are in charge of the training, and joint director, they are in charge for the treatment. And to start with there, for example, if you want to start that district medical program, and one important thing is liaison with the